What is going on out there today, people of the internet, people of YouTube? I want to thank you all very much for tuning into this video. Another unboxing and overview video. I can't hide what's in the box. You guys already know what it is from the title, the description, the thumbnail. I wish I could keep everything secret, but I just can't. Before we get into this, obviously this is an Acebeam W30 flashlight we're going to be unboxing and taking a look at here. I saw a video by an individual named Matt Smith. Go check out his channel. I'm going to link the video that I saw, and you know what, I ordered the light right after I saw his video. I had to see this for myself. Go check out his video. He's a lot more scientific than I am. Actually, check out his entire channel. He's probably forgotten more about flashlights than probably anybody watching this video actually knows. Like I said, right after I watched his video, I went to Nightcore directly, purchased this light. Yes, I purchased it. This was not given to me for review. This is not a review, just an overview. This is going to be really cool. We are using the Benchmade Griptilian as usual. Links are in the description where you can get this. Yada yada. Here we go. Getting into it. Live TV, people. Here we go. Oh boy. Well, that was kind of anticlimactic. Okay, here we go. Oh, look at this. Look at this incredible packaging. Okay. All right, well, what's in here? Oh, there we go. There it is. Flip that around. Okay, let's actually get that right out of there. Okay, let's put that there. What else did I get here? I also picked up an extra battery. Also in the box is a loose micro USB cable. Okay, let's get these out of the way. Acebeam W30, pretty cool box. Look at that, look at that. Ultra throw distance, 2,408 meters. Apparently it's good for hunting and diving. Check out the various applications this light is good for, as showcased on the box. Hunting, construction, first aid, patrol, diving, and aiming. And on the back there's a whole bunch of technical mumbo jumbo. You can pause the screen and read that if you'd like. Okay, this is already being opened. Probably by customs. Alright, let's see what we got here. There we go. Anything in here? I don't know. What about in here? There's something in there. USB cable, I'm thinking. Before we get into the actual light itself, inside those two little Acebeam boxes, all of these items were included. There's a lanyard, two O-rings, a micro USB cable, and looks like some kind of sleeve for some other size batteries. Okay, here we go. Here's the light itself. It has the included red filter already installed on the light. And I guess this just screws right off like this. That's pretty cool. There you go, check that out. Got a clicky style tail cap. The interface is extremely easy. You just have a momentary with a slight press and a constant with the click. This right here is apparently a fuel gauge. It'll glow green if everything's good, red if it's not so good. This must come off to expose the battery. It comes with one of these. It's a 21700 battery. I don't have any of these. 5100 milliamp hour. I'm thinking that's going to take a little while to charge. There's that micro USB connection at the top. I discovered this by accident. Apparently you can unscrew the head from the body this way and remove the battery like that as well. I discovered that totally by accident there. You have double O-ring protection on both sides. These batteries are branded by Acebeam. The included battery sleeve accepts 18650s perfectly. Double O-rings on both sides is probably a good thing. They say this light is submergible to 100 meters. Says right here on the light, warning, do not look into the beam. From what I understand, there's a blue laser inside the light. When you click the tail cap, it engages the blue laser, fires, bounces off a mirror, goes this way, bounces off another mirror, goes back into the light, excites a bunch of phosphor, creates a bunch of white light, and then that is shot out the front of the light through a double convex lens. This is kind of interesting. On the underside, it has this little cutout here. Looks like you could stick it on a tripod. And yes, indeed, it does have a tripod attachment. This is a Manfrotto B3 Advanced tripod. It just clips right in like that. When it's in the tripod, the fuel gauge is right on top. Does have a pocket clip. Got a spot on the back tail cap here for a lanyard as well. Right on the side of the light right here, there's also another spot you can attach a lanyard. Rotates around, so I guess you can position your lanyard wherever you want. A little bit of a crannulated bezel, I guess you call it. For a size comparison, that's the closest I can get. At least that gives you some idea. They rate this at 500 lumens. And according to that Matt Smith, don't forget to check out that video, it is 1.8 million candela. I saw the video and I thought, no way, I have to see this. And here it is. I think we need to take this outside and see what it can do. Before we go out and test this light, I really wanted to make sure that the batteries were fully charged. So I charged this one up and it took quite a while to charge. I want to say it was in the charger for over 3 hours. It's a micro USB. It's kind of interesting. I've never used one of those before. I do like it. I think it's a pretty cool innovation. So we have this 21700 battery fully charged. We're also going to be utilizing the included battery sleeve and we're going to be using an 18650 from Surefire. We're going to give that a try as well. Also, just for fun and for a point of reference, we're going to be comparing the beam of the W30 to the P3X Fury Tactical. I know they're not really going to compare. It's just going to give you some form of reference. It's going to give me a form of reference as well. This flashlight here is powered by 3 CR123s. I have 3 brand new ones in here right now. We're also going to play around a little bit with this red diffuser. You know what? I think it's time we got out there. Okay, everybody, we are out here in the flashlight testing facility. We have the W30 in hand. Let's rock this thing. Oh my God, look at this. It literally is like a laser beam of light. Bring it down to the lower level here. You know what this reminds me of? It reminds me of some kind of alien scanning device from Star Trek. Or an alien probe. Remember when Lieutenant Worf would say, "We're being probed"? This is insane. Okay, by contrast, let's try the Surefire P3X Fury Tactical. Quite a bit different. I'm going to hold the P3X on, then shine the W30 inside its beam. Oh, wow. We're now going to give this light a try with the included battery adapter and a Surefire 18650 battery. I'm honestly not seeing any difference in the beam intensity at all. I can't believe how bright it is against this front wall. Okay, I have the red diffuser on the W30. Let's check it out. Up on the far wall. This is actually kind of creepy. It's just this red orb. Bring it down to this nearest wall here. Okay, I think it's time to go test this in some other environments. Let's see what kind of damage we can do.
Using the torch to light up the pathway is problematic, to say the least. It's highly focused, there's almost no spill. And if the light touches any nearby objects, like this plant, for example, here, it completely destroys your night vision. It's extremely bright. But man, does it throw a long beam. It is insane how far this light reaches. This apartment building I'm lighting up right now is 600 meters away. It's actually 614 meters away. Lighting up the tennis court down in the park. This particular apartment building I'm about to illuminate here is 537 meters from here. It's actually lighting up the walls in the back of the rooms. Here's what it looks like going through tall brush with this light. It's not very helpful at all. Let's just pause here, I'll break out the Surefire. By contrast, this is the Surefire P3X Fury. Little bit more helpful for navigation. I've put the red filter on, and basically it turns it into a really focused point of red light. I'm going to test the light out using the 18650. Again, I'm not noticing any loss of brightness or anything. That zoomed in to the max. I have no idea how far away that tree is, probably 50 meters at least. So you can get an idea of how focused this beam is. It really is like a laser beam of white light. Okay, I think we've got the gist of the light. I think it's time to go back to the bunker and formulate some final thoughts. It's 9 o'clock in the morning, the day after the flashlight testing you just saw. We're back in the flashlight testing facility in the daytime. Unbelievable. We're using the same battery we were using last night in the Acebeam W30. Check this out. On that back wall, you can still clearly see the light. Look at that birdhouse there. Light that up. Let's bring it down. Let's put it on my pumpkins there. That's my pumpkin patch. There's a pumpkin right there. Bring it down to that first wall. Pretty amazing. All right, let's go inside the bunker for some final thoughts.
We are back in the bunker. Let's have some final thoughts, a little bit of a discussion about the Acebeam W30. Really cool flashlight, worked really well with that Surefire 18650 as well. First of all, let me say, I believe that this is pretty much just a novelty flashlight. It's just for fun. I don't really know what use anybody would actually have for something like this other than just going out and having fun. I guess maybe if you need needed a super bright, super concentrated spotlight beam for whatever your purposes may be, this would probably be the light for you. I really like the size of the light, especially for what it's capable of. I think it's really impressive it's in such a small size. It's pretty cool you can clip it onto a tripod. Again, I don't really know why you would do that. Again, maybe your usage entails a tripod and a super intense spotlight. I don't know. And if that's the case, post a video. I'd like to see it. Speaking of videos, they say that this light is submersible up to 100 meters in water. I would like to see that. If anybody has video of them scuba diving with their Acebeam W30s, please post it up. I want to see that as well. I also want to throw out there, I have no idea why this has a pocket clip, but it is there. Do they think you're actually going to clip this into your pocket? I don't think this light is too particularly durable, especially when you match it up to the Surefire P3X Fury here. I know what everybody's going to say, oh, it's a Surefire. Well, let me tell you this, the Acebeam was well over $100 more than the Surefire. And I can tell you the Surefire, just by holding them, the Surefire is a lot more durable than the Acebeam. It says here on the box, impact resistant 1 meter. I don't know. I'm not about to test it. Just to give you guys a little bit of perspective, they say that the AW30 is drop safe to 1 meter. My fender on my Jeep here is 1.07 meters from the top of that fender to the ground there. So 1 meter is not very high. I think waist height is the highest you would ever want to let that light fall, especially if it's falling onto a hard surface like this. And you know what? Even at 1 meter, I don't know. I'm skeptical it would come out unscathed. It completely destroys your night vision. If the beam is too close, if it hits any object that's close to you, it'll completely obliterate any night vision you have. It's almost like looking into the sun. You know when you look in the sun, you get these brown spots in your vision? That's what this beam does up close. If you're going to use it indoors, I haven't really played around with it too much inside, but if I was going to, if I wanted to light up a room or something, I would probably just aim it at the ceiling and use the spill from the ceiling to light the room up rather than try and illuminate individual objects, because you can't even look at them. It's so bright, it literally almost hurts your eyes. It doesn't quite hurt them, but it's irritating. I actually am surprised how focused the beam actually is. I didn't realize how tight it was going to be until I actually got the light in my hand. They do give you a heat warning on here, but I didn't find the heat to be that bad. I mean, not as bad as you would think with a light this bright and intense. All the heat I found to be back here in the body of the light, not so much up here near the lens. It's kind of interesting. Pretty cool flashlight. There's the light right there on the floor of the bunker. It's so bright, it actually almost hurts my eyes to look at it. Even though the lights are on right now, this is crazy. You guys have to see this for yourselves. All in all, I think it's a pretty cool light. It's definitely a neat light in the collection. Even though it is a Chinese-made light, sometimes you have to go outside the box. You know what, in this day and age, I don't know. I don't even know if my principles even matter anymore. Anyway, in any event, go out and get yourself an Acebeam W30 if you are interested. I have a link in the description, Amazon affiliate link. Help out the channel, shop through the links. People, follow me on all associated social media. Thank you for watching. If indeed you still are, hold your head up high. Never look down the ground. I'll catch all you on the next video. It'll be very soon. See ya!